Hi, I'm Paul. This video is a head and shoulders portrait demonstration and I'm going to talk you through the main stages from start to finish. My model is a friend, Josh Wright. Josh is a brilliant concert pianist. His face is well known to all of us through his wonderful library of concert performances and piano tutorials here on YouTube. Josh kindly sent me a video to work from, which I have on my laptop, and I'm going to work from a freeze frame as reference for the portrait. The colours I'm using are titanium white, Naples yellow, yellow ochre, raw sienna, cadmium orange, vermilion, light red, burnt sienna, raw umber, viridian, cobalt blue, cobalt violet, and lamp black. And the brushes, a selection of flat hog's hair and round nylon. The canvas is 20x28 inches, which is a good size for a head and shoulders portrait, and I'm going to give the canvas a thin wash of yellow ochre acrylic paint to break the starkness of the white canvas, and this colour will show through, no doubt, in many places in the finished painting. There are many ways to start an oil painting. The way I paint is to begin loosely, sketching out the rough placement of the head in raw umber, diluted with terps to make the paint flow more easily, like watercolour. The next stage is to dab over the raw umber with an approximate flesh colour. It's good to cover the whole face quickly, as it's really only a foundation for the later corrective glazing stages, so there's no need to go into any of the details of the face. Time to add a bit of background colour and the suggestion of the jacket. The ochre canvas tint will be part of the painting and I'm intentionally not going to paint over it completely. Now I need to work out the position of the eyes, nose and mouth in a bit more detail. I've finished the halfway point underpainting stage, so I'm going to leave the painting to dry overnight. It's the following morning and yes, I can feel the painting has dried, so I can move on to the glazing stage, which depends on the underpainting being dry. Glazing is adding varnish or a painting solvent to the oil paint so we can wash colour over the thicker underpainting. A bit like adding a wash of watercolour, just using oil paint and varnish instead. As the varnish dries very quickly, you can glaze away in many layers at a single sitting. The glazing stage needs a lot of care and concentration, and for Josh's portrait, I'll take a few hours, so I'll speed up the video, which will give you a general idea of the final corrective glazing stage. I think I'm about finished now, so when that feeling comes, it's usually best to stop, at least in this loose style of direct painting. Once again, thanks to Josh for being such a good model, and to you. Thanks for watching.